And we have those wars that are far away, but then closer to home, there are groups like you are referring to them as double eagles. Mm-hmm. Maybe you could talk about them just a little. They're kind of like the Green Berets, horribly thinking, you know, thinking of that in a way that's, it's, I don't mean to denigrate that, but that is a, they were the core that seemed.
And they're very much based on reality is the scary part. You know, the real life group was called the Silver Dollar Group. Hmm. You can find out about them if you Google Stanley Nelson or the Silver Dollar Group. You know, the Yankees tend to think that the South, the Klan is running amok in bed sheets all the time and whatever. Truthfully, the Ku Klux Klan was infiltrated and pretty much neutralized by 1965 in a lot of ways. They still, they committed some horrific acts, but as a group, neutralized. The Silver Dollar Group was a hardcore group of men, partly military veterans, who knew that and therefore split away and did nothing but commit murder, arson, rape, whatever, in secret. And their only mark, in the book, they carry a $20 gold piece, the double eagle. In real life, they carried a silver dollar minted in the year of their birth. Not one of those men was even arrested until 40 years after the crimes were committed. Wow. So that, to me, that just begged, the story begged to be told to a larger audience, you know?
And that leads us to something else, where you commit these crimes. And it's actually the title of the book, The Bone Tree, and all of the perhaps places that are similar to it.
Yeah, and the Bone Tree, I'll tell you, is a product of my imagination in the sense that the Bone Tree, as I describe it, actually exists. You know, a 700-year-old cypress that 15 men could fit inside, that's a real thing. In real life, what I base that on, it was known in the 60s to the FBI that there was a torture house in Adams County or Concordia Parish where African-American men were taken, also some Caucasian men. You know, frequently the Ku Klux Klan claverns, would have a pastor or preacher in a high position of authority. Wow. And in some cases, they would retaliate against white men who committed adultery or sold alcohol to minors, or crazy things you wouldn't believe. But I didn't want to use something as simple and prosaic as a house. Mm-hmm. I wanted something that would symbolize that atavistic component of human, the human psyche, and for me that was the Bone Tree in the swamp proved to be the idyllic thing.